reacts. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, and we are live. What's up, guys? George the Cloud here. My name is Jorge, aka George. Welcome to the channel and welcome to my life. So a few hours ago, right in the middle of the afternoon, I took a nap, as I usually do. I love naps as much as the next guy. And I had a dream that I was pregnant, and that slightly concerned me, considering I am 100% male. But anyway, today we're checking out Frosty Grand Beatbox Battle 2023 World League Producer Showcase Round 1. And this actually threw me off, since I thought we had seen all the other showcases. I completely was unaware that Frosty qualified from last year. So this was a huge surprise. And I'm very excited, very happy, because Frosty is a beast, a monster in producing. I mean, looping as it is, but more so producing. And I'm assuming it's the last one. Let me know, because this would be the sixth, and I'm pretty sure there's no more unless they surprise me again. But if they do, no problem, no issues whatsoever. I love this category and I love looping. So far, Saijo's number one for me. Check out all the other reactions. It'll be at the top right at the end of this video on a playlist. I won't speak anymore because the intro is getting kind of long, and I know you guys have things to do. You have to brush your teeth, you have to make pancakes, you have to clean your bed, and not in that order. But anyway, get some popcorn, fill up your water, put your headphones on. Let's...
Let's begin. Hit him with the glitch.
That brings us to the last battler in the producer category. I see you left side, right side, everybody in between. Y'all ready? Yeah. From the UK. GBB Online Champion.
GBB Online Champion.
No stranger to the stage as well, because he's been here for also Katya. Can I go and get a big round of applause for Frosty?
I love his name. I love Frosty. He really looks like Frosty the Snowman.
Left side, right side, front to back, everybody in between, are you ready for the last producer?
Yes.
Frosty, it's on you. You already know what to do. I say the three, y'all.
Hold on. Why does Tio Neb look so serious here? And actually, quick question. Is Tio Neb a judge, or is he just kind of supervising the cameras and everything, making sure people aren't cheating? But actually, everyone here looks super, like, I don't know, like they're taking a math test or something, except Tom Thumb. He's having the time of his life. But everyone else here, even Inky, they're like, oh my god. Can we go home? I don't know. Just seems like they're... Anyway.
Frosty, it's on you. You already know what to do. I say the three, y'all say the two and the one. In 3, 2, 1,
beatbox!
Oh my god. Guys, I'm sorry. I'm sorry about the ads. That's it. That's all I can do. Just apologize and move on. We keep rolling. I haven't heard Frosty in such a long time. In like a year and a half or something. With the red lights, intense.
Oh,
building up the atmosphere.
Star to fight.
Once again, big up to Frosty right there, repping that UK. Can I get a round of applause for Frosty? Come on!
拍手お願いします。Frosty でした。
Yo, it's Frosty. Thank you for watching the video. You can follow me on social media on Instagram at Frosty Beatbox and YouTube at Frosty Beatbox.
All right, guys. I'm just going back to my playlist because I have to figure out what order I ranked these people. Okay, but first things first. We hit the like, we subscribe. I'll have a link of the original video down in the description below. Okay. This was classic Frosty. I mean, he always has kind of this dark demeanor about him. Final boss energy. The lights are red, kind of eerie, dark, right? Sinister. And he has all these sounds that, I don't know, I would like how to describe them. They're like lasers. They seem like they're coming from outer space, different galaxies, from aliens, basically. It's like a synth that is piercing through you, accompanied by that heavy bass, and it sounds gnarly, it sounds deep. I was actually trying to picture, like, imagine seeing Frosty, right? Looping, producing, in a cave, in a mountain, in Iraq. Somewhere like that. I think Iraq has a lot of mountains. Because isn't there myths and legends about giants in the mountains of Iraq? Or is that Pakistan? Somebody let me know. Or Iran. I'm not sure. I don't know much about, you know, the Middle East. But I'm just picturing him being in that environment, kind of dark at night. He's inside a cave. Super, you know, disturbing. And you just see the table and all the machinery, and he's looping, and he, you know, comes out with this track. I think that's kind of the place I would picture. That's an idea for him. He should do a visualizer for a wildcard or something, or just a video, if you know, if he wants, with that kind of imagery. I would really, it's so fitting. At least that's how I pictured him. But yeah, it started off kind of slow. You know, while he was doing the build-up, he was kind of taking his time with it, no rush. Everything still seemed intentional. And that's the thing about Frosty. He's always very kind of chill. He doesn't integrate too much with the crowd. Like, his stage presence isn't the strongest, I'm going to say. He doesn't make eye contact that much. He's just kind of, you know, in his own zone, doing his thing. But he always looks kind of like relaxed, or maybe not relaxed, but it's like he's focused, and he looks like he's doing a good job. I don't know how to describe it. Like, he doesn't look phased or nervous or anything like that. It's just kind of mid, if not in a bad way, the way they use mid now. But yeah, then towards the middle, he gave us a remix of what is it? Falling from Grace, I think that's what the track is called. One of the hardest hitting, most nastiest, dirtiest, filthiest tracks in Loop Station history. We saw it at the kickback against Robin, which would have defeated anyone else probably if Robin didn't come out with like his masterpiece on top of the car. But it was so insane. I still remember when I heard that. I watched that video so many times, so many reaction channels. That's actually, I think, when I started getting the idea of making my own reaction channel, when I was in the middle of my kickback journey and all these amazing videos were coming out and so many people were reacting to them. So this is bringing me back. And then he also played this track at GBB 20... What is it, 2023? See, now I'm getting mixed up with the years because they've been... God damn it. No, 21. Yeah, GBB 21 against Rhythmind. And that was epic. So to see it again here, very cool. It was a little bit different. He changed up the lyrics. He was saying, like, you know, I Am Death. And yeah, it was solid. I think it maybe lacked a bit of, I don't know, like more range, because for the most part it was like with the heaviness, with the drops. And I've been saying this before and I'll say it again, that's why I enjoy Saijo so much, because he knows how to strategize and make it more like make the dynamic work, right? You go, you know, you do the lows and then you get the highs, and then so the drops have more of an impact when your sound changes. I don't know if I'm making any sense whatsoever. Is this even English at this point? But I feel like Frosty's whole showcase kind of stayed in this range instead of making a roller coaster, which I would have enjoyed more. And see, the crowd, they didn't seem that into it. I mean, they probably were. It's just with this kind of music, it's hard to, you know, you're not going to be dancing, you know, jumping up and down at all times, because it's dark and eerie, so you don't know how to move. I think that's what's going on here, because I'm pretty sure they enjoyed it. It's just I didn't see the crowd going that hyped as I expected, and that kind of plays a role psychologically in me choosing the rankings. And now we go to the rankings. Not that this even matters at all, since this already happened, but let's see the ones we have checked out. This is what I'm saying, guys. I have a playlist of the Grand Prix Box Battle 2023, 57 videos that I have reacted to. And here are the producer categories. So number one, still going to be Saijo. Number two, Antrix.
What? Oh my God.
Number three, I think Chaos. Number four, Freedon. I'm going to put Frosty at number five, believe it or not. And number six, KBA. That's just my personal rankings, guys. No hard feelings. Of course, with all due respect, I really enjoyed all of them. It's just the others were more like intense for me, in the sense that I guess I connected more with the track, especially when there's vocals. That's why I keep mentioning Saijo. I like even Antrix vocals, Freedon. But yeah, it was still solid. It's just I don't think, you know, compared to the others, it lacked what is the just kind of more excitement. I think it's what it is, more of a lighter note. It was too dark, if that's even possible. But yeah, I still enjoyed it. It was solid. Let me know what you guys thought of it, because I'm always curious to read your comments. Maybe I'm alone in the dark by myself in a cloud floating away into outer space. I don't know. Or maybe you agree, and if you agree, what the heck, hit the like, subscribe, share, hit me up on Instagram. I'll keep saying it every video if I need to. At George the Cloud. And at the end, do a flip. Till the next.
Thanks for watching.